Good morning students, welcome to the class. In the previous class we completed up to the image file format and the layers of the digital image. Okay, so today we will discuss about the filter and image manipulation. Okay, so let us discuss in detail. Filters. An image filter is a technique through which size, color, shading, and other characteristics of an image are altered. That means, in the image filter concept or image filter process, we change the size, we change the color, we change the shading, and other characteristics of the image we can change or alter or modify. Okay, an image filter is used to transform the image using different graphical editing techniques. Image filters are usually done through graphic design and editing software. This is primarily used to edit an image using computer software. An image filter generally changes the image at the pixel level. That means each pixel is individually affected. It can be applied 2D and 3D images also. Okay. Typically, the image filter process includes editing the color scheme, theme, contrast of the image, adjusting the image brightness and adding effect to the image and the changing the structure and changing the texture. Okay, all these things can be included in the image filter process. Filter is used for changing the appearance of an image in the multimedia. The features which are not of our interest are suppressed during filtering. Suitable condition or criteria are chosen to focus the features of an image during the filtering. That means during filtering process, we define that different types of condition or different types of situation which only we can create in the images. Okay. Filtering is a set of tools in image processing packages which change the appearance of an image by applying some effects. Okay. Filters are used to change the appearance of an image layer or selection in Photoshop. That means in the Photoshop, we select the layer and change the appearance of the picture. Filters can be categorized into four types according to the or depending on the effect of the image. Okay, first one is your edge filter, normal filter, special filter, user defined filter. These four types of filter depending on their effects on the image. First we discuss about edge filter. This type of filter changes the edge of an image without affecting the interior part. In the edge filter, we only change the edges. Next one is our normal filter. This filter used in most of the image editing packages such as soften or sharpen the picture. Okay. Next one is our special filter. Special type of filter available in image editing package which facilitate for adding noise or distort. Okay, and last one is our user defined filter. It is used for user requirements. That means in this four type of filter we filter out the image or define the pure quality pictures. That means in the edge filter we change the edges of the image, in the normal filter we change or we filter the soften or sharpen portion of the image or editing the image, and in spatial filter we remove the adding noises or disturb which is added in our images. Okay, that things also we removes using the spatial filter. And in user defined filter, it is you the requirements the user which he want, he or she want. Okay, that means the requirements of the user, if anything changes according to the user requirement, that for that things are changes using user defined filter. Okay, so this one, this much is your concept of filtration. Next is our image manipulation. Okay, image manipulation refers to a process of bringing changes to a digitized image for transferring it to a desired image. Okay, the changes are made possible by resorting to image processing. That means in this process we change the images and transferring in a desired form. Okay, a desired image which we want to change, which we want to changes, or which we user require. Okay, the changes made possible by resorting to image processing process. Next is our next method is our scaling. Okay, scaling does not change the image pixel in any way. It only action is to change the single number for DPI, a dot per inch or pixel per inch, which only changes the size of the image will print on paper. That means scaling means we only changes the size. Okay, it has no effect on images on computer screen. Scaling is sometimes called resize and resample, in even sometimes called scaling. So the terms can be questionable what they actually mean in the given uses. Okay, here scaling is about changing the size the image will print on a paper, that means inches, specifically without any pixel resampling. Okay, it is about declaring the DPI number, that means dots per inch, in preparation for printing a certain size on paper. This is by far the simplest operation, but sometimes a bit harder to grasp it. So scaling stretches the image on the paper without changing any actual pixel. It changes only the actual DPI number, that means from one place to another place, not change the size. It will only move this only change the number, dots per inch number. Okay, that means printing resolution, spacing of the pixel on the paper, which changes only the number of inches the same image pixel will fill on paper. That means spaced so many pixels per inch. Okay, because the image simply prints larger with a smaller DPI, or prints smaller with a larger DPI number. Okay, so this is your concept of scaling. That means in image manipulation we change the image in different method. Okay, first one is your scaling method. Next is our cropping. There are usually two purposes for cropping: compositional enlargement, like zooming the camera so we can remove any surrounding blank space, trimming away any uninteresting or distracting areas around our image, concentrating the subject larger, leaving only what we want to see for a better or more pleasing view. Okay, and also very important, we can make our image shape fit the paper shape. So something important won't be cut off past the edge or off the paper. Okay, that means we crop the image for the zooming the camera, so we can remove any surrounding blank space, trimming uninteresting objects or distracting around the our image, or concentrating the subject on the particular subject or particular image, and for better pleasing view. Okay, you can see the two different shape, the shape here. The overall image aspect ratio is 2:3, that is taller narrow shape, and another one is a 4:5, which is your marked rectangular shape. Marked rectangular shape is also known as shorter wider shape. This one is your narrow shape, 2:3 ratio, and 4:5 ratio is your wider shape. Okay, when crop area is selected, and then the menu image crop will trim away all else, leaving only the area we marked to be included. That means when you crop this, only the image area, the portion which we crop this, the selected area, that means the image the area which you only marking. Okay, marked. So this one is your concept of cropping. Next is our rotation. Rotation is a noun and the means the act or process of turning around an axis or the center. Okay, in mathematics, rotation is a circular motion of a configuration around a line or given point without changing the shape. That means rotation either clockwise or anticlockwise. So here, when you start Photoshop, open the image to be rotated, click the rotate from the image menu and choose the degree of rotation, and enter a specific number, select free and type the number, click OK, save the file number. That means in which degree we can rotate, in the left side or in the right side portion. Okay, so in this way your rotation concept is another methods of the image manipulation. So this much in this class. Your unit 11 chapter will be completed. Okay, and another last chapter only left, which we'll discuss in the next class. So thank you.